Hi there! In this video, we will talk about the new updates of the table feature in Artboard Studio. As you may know, we already released this tool, which you can create a table like this on your canvas, and then import text data into your table and connect those text data to your design. And it will give you different variations based on how many rows you have. For example, if I choose the table with the text inside and say sync artboards, it gives me 5 different variations of this design on my canvas like this with different languages. Now, with this new update, we have included media and color formats to tables. So now you can extend your table and choose a column format from text, color, and media. If you choose your column format as media, you can double click on the cell and choose any image from your computer with this upload and replace. You can choose any image from your canvas from this option, or you can easily paste image URL to this input in order to place your media inside this column. For example, now I'm going to use upload and replace, and I will choose a photo from my computer, double click, and it will instantly upload the image and place inside my table, inside my D column. And then I can go to my design and connect this column to any image on my artboard. I'm just dragging the handle from the top of the column here and trying to connect to an image. And as you see, it's just snapping around the items on my canvas and waiting for me to select which image I want to replace with this one I just uploaded. In this example, as you see, I have 1, 2, 3, and 4 different images. I can create more columns for each image and place an image or URL to generate variations. For this example, I need 4 different media columns too. I create new columns and I'm choosing media format. Also, now you can right click on the table and say clone column to the right to duplicate the exact same column. Let me use this right click menu instead of this. I'm just right clicking on the column and saying clone column to the right. And as you see, it instantly creates a column with the same media format and with the same URL. Now, if I want to use different images for each image here, I just double click and say upload and replace again. Now choosing another image and waiting for it to be uploaded. And I can also preview which image uploaded and assigned to this column. Now I'm dragging an image to my canvas here. Now I'm choosing select from canvas option. The moment I click on select from canvas option, as you see, my mouse is turning into a pointer, which I can go to my canvas and pick any image on my canvas. Now, if I go to F column here, I can also see small little thumbnails to preview which image assigned. Now, I need one more column for the other image. And turning this, changing the format of the column from the button here, like this. Then I double click and I say upload and replace. For the last image, let's say I'm going to use this one. Now, on top of media columns, now we also have color option. If I turn this column format into color, it means I can apply any color. Let's say I'm going to use this same orange here as a color. Now, I can assign this color column to any layer on my artboard. I can use this as a color for my text, or I can use this color as fill color for any shape, or I can assign this to an artboard as a background color. The moment I drag this color to my artboard, it just snaps to artboard and it tells me I'm going to apply this solid color to the background color. And let's say you want to change the color or images in the middle of the way, so you can also do that. Because you are not working on the canvas, you are assigning assets and colors on the table. So you can again double click and change the color anytime, and it will instantly reflect on the artboard and also it will instantly reflect the cell like you see here. Now I added images, but I didn't assign them. So the first one, the D column, replaced this image. Now I'm dragging the E column as a media to replace this image. Repeating the same step for other images too. For the F column, change this one, and the G column goes to this one. And maybe I can change the background color to something maybe brighter like this. Now, if I play the animation from the beginning, all my data, all my colors and images, and also the text here, which I defined before, goes and changes the placeholders on my artboard. Now, the next step is defining other images for other rows in order to create several different variations out of this one master design. For that, I can also use URL for images. So for the second version, I need to add another image from this website. I just go to this website and clicking on this product. So here I can right click and say copy image address. Come back to my table and paste into the media picker URL input here and pressing enter. It instantly uploads the image and also plays this image into my cell, which means in the second version, this image will replace this one here, because this column connected to this image. Now I'm just repeating the same step for other images too, copying the image address and pasting into URL, repeating the same steps for other images too. This is great for e-commerce campaigns. For example, if you have lots of products and categories in your marketing campaign, you can easily generate variations by just copying and pasting image links. And using one master design, you can create unlimited variations out of your design. I just filled the cells with the image URLs for the second version. Now I can define a background color, a different color for the second design. So my product is including some colors like a purplish color, so I can use a purplish background color for this. Of course, I can always change this color anytime I like. Now, this table will give me 5 different versions because other cells also includes text which is connected to this text. But for this example, let me delete those rows here. I can also use this handle to crop the table like this. Then I can delete other tables because I don't need them to make this demo faster. Now I'm going to use other source for my images. Let's go to the left toolbar, the add items menu here, and go to stock photos and go to Unsplash and make a search for fashion because all other designs are related to fashion. Now, if I add images from Unsplash to my canvas like this, I'm clicking and adding this one. I don't know, maybe going to this one, and maybe this one, because I need 4 different images for 4 different placeholders like here. So again, I double click on the cell, and in the media picker, I say select from canvas. For the first image, I will go with this one. For the second image, I will go with this one. For the third one, for the F column, I will go with maybe this one. And lastly, for the G column, I will go with this one. So let me check if all images are different, and yes. Also, I can again double click and update this image anytime I like. For the other artboard background color, I'm gonna go with maybe a dark brown color like this. Cool. Now, if I select the table and click on the sync artboard, it's going to give me different variations out of the same design with different background colors and with different images. And as you see in the second row, we defined the French language and also defined different images and different background color. It goes and applies to the second artboard here. So this way I don't need to repeat same design, or I don't need to duplicate and change images all the time. I can easily import my data to the table and generate variations in no time. Yeah, now I type my Turkish content too, which is the next variations is going to include the Turkish language. Again, I'm selecting the table and I'm saying sync artboards. Now, as you see, it keeps the French language and the last one turned into Turkish version, getting the data, getting the text data from those rows. Also, we added a right click for tables feature. For example, you can right click on the column and define a color. Let's say you want to separate those assets with different colors to make the organization or teamwork much easier. In this example, I'm marking image layers with orange and I'm marking background colors with blue. This way you can explain better to your colleague to which data they need to organize. And also you can double click on the title part and rename your titles like this. Also, you can right click and clone columns like this. You can right click and say insert column to the right for adding empty columns, or you can right click and say clone column to the right, which is copying the same content and creating a new column for you. And yeah, that's how the table feature works with the new update. The most important update was adding and defining the formats for each column. We now bring media formats, which you can import your images or videos. And we also bring color format for columns, which is defining the background or object colors on your canvas. And this way, you can easily create one master animation or design with videos or images. Then you can create variations out of this master design, unlimited variations, based on the data you included in this table and based on the rows you filled. So if you have any questions and feedback, we're looking forward to your feedback on the comment section. And also you can follow the link in the description to test out this new update or feature yourself. Take care. Bye.